you came to America as an international student from where?
From West Africa, Togo.
What year was that?
2004.
Shortly after you arrive, you get a big financial lesson about this country and yourself. Tell me about that.
Well, you know, it's kind of very interesting because in West Africa, you know, we don't have the same economy that we have here in the U.S. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't have credit card that's much more developed. So my first mistake was with a credit card. you know, when you're like on campus, you know, they come to you, they tell, hey, you know, this is a T-shirt, sign here. There's a credit card, you have $2,000 on it. I was so excited. So I signed up for it, I don't know what I was signed for. Right after I went to the mall, I started swiping it, buying clothes and shoes and having a good time. Mm. And then the rest is story.
How bad did the debt get?
Well, you know, it got so bad because I didn't first know the interest rate on that car was like 22%. I didn't know that. I didn't know what interest rate was back then even. Mm. That was the bad part.
Okay.
You know, I thought it was free money. You know, that someone
just handed it to me. Yes.
You know, so I was paying just the minimum payment. And I realized that the balance was still the same. So one day I was like, you know, let me just call them and see what's going on. Mm-hmm. So when I called, it was Capital One, and I called, and I was so lucky that one nice woman answered the phone, and she told me, honey, you can just pay the minimum. You have to pay more than the minimum. So she was very nice to educate me into the process. We were like on the phone for like about half an hour, you know. So that was like a quick lesson. But what really helped me this whole process was like my dad. You know, I was very fortunate that, you know, when I came here, I should get some money every month, you know, send me some money. You know, so I thought I was entitled to it. I thought I was like, you know, it's going to be all the time. Well, we didn't sign a contract. There was no agreement, right?
There's no contract exactly. Between you and dad.
So one day he called me, he said, son, you know, we love you so much, but, you know, I think we're done. And I said, what do you mean we're done? I said, yeah, you know, we're not going to get any money whatsoever. You know, the only kid that I have. And I said, well, what do you want me to do? He said, you figure it out. That's it. That's it.
You figure it out.
Yeah.
And you figured it out?
And I did.
How long did that take?
Well, you know, I'm still figuring out right now. Mm-hmm. You know, it is a process. You know, I have a destination. I have a target that I want to reach. So it's still a target. It's still a process. Mm-hmm. But, you know, the best thing about that, when you don't have an option, things work in your favor. Mm-hmm. When you have two options, that's where you get confused. That's where you don't reach your potential.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You got no option. Now, let's fast forward. You've written a book now based on some of those lessons you've learned in college. And it's called Screw College Debt.
Well, the first one is Cash In With Your Money.
Cash In With Your Money.
Yeah.
Okay, and the one that's out now, the next one coming out is
Screw College Debt.
Let's talk about Screw College Debt.
Okay.
and it's how to get through college without breaking the bank.
Without breaking the bank.
Many would say, first off, is college still essential today? Because it is getting really, really expensive, and no one looks at college and think they won't be able to break the bank unless they're wealthy. Do you still think college is critical today?
It is.
What makes you say that?
I think it is a gateway to achieve certain things in life. But also, I'm gonna contradict myself, saying that college is not a path to success.
Not a path to success. Many people think they think so. And why do you say that?
Well, because, you know, I think we live in a society right now where, you know, we can't just look at education, college education, be like the only way to you to reach whatever you want to reach out to. To some people, it could be right. For some others, they need some other avenue to get there.
Mm-hmm. Good deal. Good deal. In terms of the cost of college, does that blow your mind how expensive it is right now?
Well, you know that, Ephraim, you know, like years ago, you can work part-time or full-time and pay for college. Mm-hmm. It's not the case anymore. It's not anymore.
No.
Right now, we are at more than $1.2 trillion, the outstanding U.S. college debt here in the U.S. The question I'm going to ask you, I'm going to ask everybody, how are we going to pay for it and who is going to pay for it? Pretty much the same thing happened on the housing market. Well, we borrow too much, and then we didn't have a value of it. Mm-hmm. We can apply the same thing in college. People borrow too much, they graduate, they didn't find an exact job, or maybe unemployed. Mm-hmm. So they have this big debt, mm-hmm. and they have this little salary.
Right.
But keep in mind that when you're like in high school, you're so excited, you get into college, you know, you take all those school, all those debt. Well, you forget when you get out, college is not your only debt. You have a credit card, you have your car payment. If you start family, mm-hmm. how are you going to do that?
Absolutely.
You know, if for instance, like, you know that your salary is gonna be $35,000 after college, if your college debt is like $80,000, you will screw. Mm-hmm. You are.
Yeah, very much so. So what's your advice to college students?
Well, you have to look at college as an investment. First of all, you have to ask yourself, it is a personal question, why are you going to college? Question number one. Mm-hmm. Secondly, what are you gonna do with it? So, third, how are you gonna pay for it?
Why are you going to college? What are you gonna do with it, and how are you gonna pay for it?
Exactly.
When it comes to the how I'm gonna pay for it, if parents can't, what do you suggest they do?
Well, you know, I'm a big fan of community college, mm-hmm. to be honest with you. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm a big fan of it. I think community college is a great way for parents, students to get to college education a cheaper way, but also to get an experience and start working mm-hmm. while going back to the 4 years institution. That's okay. One thing. Mm-hmm. Secondly, parents can also start investing for their kids if they have the means. Things like 529 plan, things like a Roth IRA, mm-hmm. things like Carverdale plan. Scholarships, there's tons of them out there, but we don't do a great job pushing our kids toward those scholarships. People always think that, you know, you have to be like, you know, Michael Jordan, you have to be that smart to get a mm-hmm. scholarship. No, there's tons of them out there and for every skill.
Where do they begin to look? What would you suggest?
Well, there's a nice, great website that I like called Fast Web. You know, mm-hmm. what it does to you, you go there, you enter all your information, mm-hmm. and it will pull, like, you know, the scholarship that will apply to you personally. You know, I mean, your grocery store has a scholarship, Target, Walmart, you know. Maybe people even, like, you know, I met a guy one day, his job has a scholarship. He didn't even know that. Mm-hmm. That he could have, like, you know, his daughter apply for it. So there's scholarships out there. It takes time, it takes work. You just have to, like, you know, give the dedication mm-hmm. and look for it.
So is one of the biggest problems in terms of paying for college lack of preparation?
Correct.
Possibly?
Lack of college planning. Mm-hmm.
When should we begin that process of planning?
As early as you can. You can't just wait till your kids, like, in a high school are about to graduate from senior and they start planning for college. That's too late. Mm.
Senior year is too late.
It's too late. Because that's when, like, you know, you don't have so many options for you. You know, you start with one option that your kid's gonna go to XYZ college. Mm-hmm. And if that fall off, what happened? Mm-hmm. You're like in a limbo. You screw.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. What do you think the effect is on our economy of this massive college debt? You're saying we're more than $1 trillion in college debt alone, not just debt, but college debt.
College debt.
Specifically. What do you think the impact on our society is?
Well, when we have that much debt, when you have people who cannot afford to pay, when you have, like, you know, 13% that are defaulting on their college debt, what do you think it's doing? It is like there's a bad debt for all those banks or institutions who lend those money. But keep in mind that there's no bankruptcy when it comes to college debt. Mm-hmm. They will chase you. They will garnish your salary. Mm-hmm. They will take your Social Security benefits, you know, things like that. But even though when you have kids that are moving back home to stay with their parents, when you have kids that cannot go and buy a car because they start with a college debt, when you have people who cannot start a family because of college debt, when you have people that deny credit because of college debt, all those stuff having a significant impact on the economy.
Indeed. Let's go back to your first book, Cashing with Your Money.
Correct.
What triggered that? What was it that happened to you that made you say, I need to write a book?
Well, it was a tough decision. You know, I come to a point, you know, after my parents cut me off, I come to realize that I had to be responsible with my money. Okay. And during that process, I start talking to different people, different mentors, different financial advisors, financial planners, asking them questions. But the main point was a financial crisis. that happened 2008, 2009. Mm. That was the most that triggered me to write that book. As I look at the whole financial crisis, what would you hear from the media? Subprime mortgage, correct? I mean, that's true. Mm-hmm. But when you look deeply, I found four reasons being the main cause of the financial crisis. First, we as a consumers are not financially educated enough to understand why we buy every day. Mm. That's what happened with my credit card, remember? Mm-hmm. I didn't know what interest rate was.
No.
I just got it, I stopped using it. Mm-hmm. Secondly, we're so greedy. We are. Mm-hmm. You know, we want something, want it right away. We don't have the money, but we want it. So we figure out how to buy it. Third, we don't know the difference between our wants and our needs. We get those so confused. Why should somebody, for instance, have the money to afford iPhone 6 Plus, no offense to Apple, mm-hmm. but does not have the money to buy a life insurance policy for his family? That's a big question mark.
Great question. Great question.
And then fourth, again, credit card, the plastic. Mm. Yeah. Because you have that perception that, okay, I'm going to swipe it today. I'm going to pay it off. But you know what? You're not going to pay it off. Your car's going to broke down. Something's going to happen. Then you're not going to pay it off. That's why you have those big companies, all those Visa, they make big money all the time. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Credit cards are our emergency fund instead of a savings account for many of us. Let's go back to you before we go. Dad cut you off when you were in college, and you had to find a way. So was community college one of the ways for you?
Correct.
And what was some of the lessons you learned?
You know, it was so funny too. You know, I have to be honest, I was not the smartest kid, you know, in college. So in my accounting classes, we done the course, I did not really understand what that lady taught that day. Mm. So I was chasing her in the parking lot with my book in my armpit. And I was like, can you please explain this to me? She's like, you know, I asked three times in class if the lesson was understood, everybody say yes. Why I didn't say anything? I was like, I was so scared, I didn't want to say anything. Mm. And she told me that I have to go. I said, you have to go where? She said, I teach at a community college. I said, really, you do? I said, where? And she gave me the name. Mm-hmm. So I went to the library, I Googled quick, and I was reading, I think it was way cheaper than what I was paying. Mm-hmm. And I went to my advisor, I said, next quarter, I'm transferring. He said, no, you know, I said, yes, I am. Mm-hmm. So that was like, you know, moment when I went to community college, mm-hmm. you know, so I get my associate degree there. You know, I work 1 year to save money and then went back to my 4-year education.
Good deal, yeah. Good deal. What's the biggest financial lesson you could give to a young person right now in high school thinking about going to college? What's the big lesson you could leave with them?
You know, I'm gonna go back again to be responsible with money. You know, that's big thing. When I mean being responsible, that means a lot. You know, that means budgeting, that means saving, that means finding ways how you're gonna pay for your college education. You know, things like, you know, scholarships, things like, you know, work through college. People always say that, no, I can't have my kid work when he's college. Well, people are doing it. Mm-hmm. That's why I say if you don't have any option, you will do it, right? Mm-hmm. So those are my two big, my big things, you know, I can address.
Good deal. Reminder, the latest book, Screw College Debt, How to Go to College Without Breaking the bank. And the other book, Cashing with Your Money.
All right. Tool for Better Financial Life.
All right. Excellent. Thank you.
Thank you, Ephraim. Thank you for having me.